Anyone who wants to be an FCA huddle leader needs to see Coach Hall today.
The following students need to come by Ms. Lou's classroom, AU33, to pick up their Spanish exemption letters before the end of the day. Jocelyn Cisneros, Samantha Rosas, Jessica Barca, Rosa Martinez, Jennifer Lopez, Michelle Huitonda, Jose Buendia, Kevin Guzman, Luis Gutierrez, Rebecca Alonzo, Walker Izara, Gustavo Espinal, David Acevedo, Oscar Andres Utera, Katie Perez, Adamariz Perez, and Adrian Perez.
The Fellowship of Christian Athletes meet every Wednesday morning at 7:30 in the chorus room. Everyone is invited to attend.
Community service opportunity. If you're interested in volunteering with the City of Calhoun Recycling Department, one of their upcoming projects to give the recycling center a facelift. They would like to paint the 5 or 6 metal recycling bins and would love to have 3 volunteers that are great artists to participate in dressing up the bins with their art. They would financially sponsor this project, so there would be no cost to the student. For more information or to volunteer, please contact Judy Peterson at the City of Calhoun Recycling Department at 706-629-4473.
More community service opportunities are available through the Gym Theater for several upcoming events. Please contact Claire Lewis at the Gym Theater at 706-625-3132 or stop by the main office for more information.
Another community service opportunity is available through the Habitat for Humanity. For more information, please contact Lana Young at 706-625-9929.
In sports, the JV volleyball team hosted their first regular season game Tuesday and defeated both Chattooga and Model in 2 sets each. Freshman Emma Smith and Aaron Kelly led the Lady Jackets in aces with 7 each. The team will travel to Maury County Thursday. Go Jackets!
And now we have some special in-studio guests to give you some important information for the start of the school year. Take it away, Mr. McCandless and Ms. Parker.
Good morning. This is Ms. Parker and Mr. McCandless live in the studio to share some important highlights and changes to our Calhoun High School student handbook. There is an interactive PowerPoint on the CHS webpage that you can refer to for any specific questions. Please pay close attention for changes to the dress code, attendance office policies, and more.
Let's start with some campus safety procedures. You will notice that it is illegal to pass a school bus that is loading or unloading on campus. Please be mindful of this if you are a student driver.
Student drivers should also be aware that you should not be talking or texting on a cell phone while you are driving, especially on campus. We've had some close calls.
Yeah, we have.
With students that were not paying attention while they were driving. I know that's hard to believe.
We would also ask that students, as well as teachers, utilize the crosswalks on campus. Thank you for your attention to these matters.
Changing gears, let's talk about some attendance office policies that may affect you. Please note that when you are absent from school, you will have 3 days to bring in an excuse. After those 3 days, the absence will be marked as unexcused.
In addition, there will be no personal checkouts by telephone. You may be checked out by telephone for doctor, dentist, or other excused appointments. Remember that failure to bring your excuse from that appointment will result in the loss of telephone checkouts.
Also, the attendance office will no longer accept outside food being delivered for lunch. Food that is brought in from an outside establishment will have to be placed in an unmarked bag. Please note that this is a system-wide policy
definitely,
at all of our definitely. Schools.
The next item discussed in the PowerPoint is the dress code. You will be taking a closer look at these pictures in your homeroom during your advisement this week. Teachers, please share these pictures with your students so that they are aware of what is acceptable and what is not. Teachers, please refer to the student handbook for information on how you should report any violations.
One dress code item to note is our change in the facial jewelry policy. Students will now be allowed to wear studs as seen in the picture on your left. You will not be allowed to wear any hoops, loops, or rings. Clear retainers are acceptable, though.
Definitely. Another new policy that will go into effect on September 1st is the new headwear policy. You will now be allowed to pay a fee for the year to wear your hat at school. Obviously, you will be expected to remove your hat for the pledge, assemblies, and when requested by a faculty member. This pass will allow you to wear your hat between classes in the hallway in the cafeteria and at various other times. As you notice, we found two violators this morning. Please see myself or Ms. Parker for more information.
Also, please be sure to check out our new detention procedure slide for more information regarding our brand new fifth period work detail detention.
Thank you for your attention this morning. We hope this information will be helpful.
Go Jackets!